In 2016, the European Southern Observatory made public the finding of an extrasolar planet that appears to be the one that is geographically located nearest to Earth. Proxima Centauri B, also known as Proxima B for short, is an exoplanet that orbits the star Proxima Centauri and is located in the habitable zone of that star. Proxima Centauri B, also known as Proxima B for short, is an exoplanet that orbits the star Proxima Centauri and is located in the habitable zone of that star. It would take just a little more than 4 light years to go there by spaceship, which is quite near by the norms of space travel, but very far when compared to the capabilities of our current technology. The constellation Alpha Centauri is moving along its massive orbit towards Earth at a speed of 22 kilometers per second, which is 3 times faster than the space shuttle moves. Right now, we have the perfect opportunity to explore this promising exoplanet, because after this phase of the approach, it'll move 700 million kilometers further away from us every year. That's almost the distance from the Sun to Jupiter. Compared to our Sun, Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf. Its diameter is 7 times smaller. It is also 8 times lighter, and its temperature is half that of our Sun. It seems relatively insignificant, yet you might live in the area. Additionally, Proxima B is 20 times closer to its star than Earth is to our Sun. This proximity may result in one side of the exoplanet always being turned towards its star, similar to how the Moon is always turned towards Earth. Additionally, this proximity may result in Proxima B's star being 20 times brighter than our Sun. Why would today's space agencies bother to spend decades traveling to Proxima B in order to convey how difficult this mission is? Let's set aside the miles or kilometers and get our space tape measure out. The distance from the Sun to Earth is equal to 1 astronomical unit, AU, which is about 150 million kilometers, and only 5 terrestrial spacecraft have ever traveled 10 times farther than that in space. The New Horizons spacecraft, which was sent into space in 2006 at a rate of 15 kilometers per second, has already completed its mission of investigating Pluto and its moons. At this moment, the probe is receding from the Sun by a distance equivalent to nearly 50 astronomical units. Endurance Race Voyager 2 has already flown over 122 astronomical units, while its twin brothers set a flight distance record of over 147 astronomical units. That is what the distance from Earth to Proxima B looks like in comparison to the achievements of our probes. And if the most advanced Voyager 1 probe decided to fly to Proxima B, it would have to overcome a distance that is 1,800 times greater. When will we be able to get our hands on some new engines that can power our intergalactic travel? We are fortunate that researchers have been working hard for a long time to find solutions to the problems with probe fuel. As a result, they are conducting research on a wide variety of alternative energy sources. However, the question remains as to whether or not they will have enough time to develop a new fuel-powered engine. Proxima B has not yet arrived at its destination on Earth. Jim Woodward and Hal Fearn, two scientists from California, are working on a project that they have called the Mega Drive. The basis of MOC seems to be a voodoo spell, nonetheless. They anticipate that their endeavor will lead in an era of cosmic space travel. Through the use of electricity and a series of crystals, the Mega Drive is able to produce vibrations and steer those vibrations in the desired direction. It's quite similar to shivering while skating in the cold, but the difference is that this time you aim your shivering forward so that its strength pulls you towards a glass of warm mulled wine instead of away from it. Although this seems crazy, it must be incredibly economical in practice. NASA already supplied cash for development, but because everything is still in the theoretical stage, you won't be able to get very far with it for the foreseeable future. Roger Shoyer, a British engineer, went even farther and built the EM drive engine, which became known as the Impossible Drive, almost immediately after its introduction. It is made out of a magnetron that, just like in a regular microwave oven, reflects microwaves and then traps them in something that is formed like a cone in order to create a significant amount of thrust. It's a green concept that runs entirely on energy, which is good for the environment. Regrettably, it is not yet feasible to provide an estimate for when the first prototype will start functioning. In the attempt to develop a thermonuclear engine, we require something more dependable than Proxima B, which is displaying fantastic results. This engine will run on the nuclear fusion energy of helium-3 and deuterium, and it is currently being modeled at the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory. If the spacecraft were powered by such an engine, it would be able to reach Pluto in just 5 years, which is twice as fast as the New Horizons probe, and it would be able to reach Proxima B in 42,000 years, which is not bad. But unfortunately, our window of opportunity has closed. According to the astronomers' calculations, it would have been closed by then. In 27,000 years, both Proxima Centauri and its exoplanet will start rapidly receding from our solar system in their orbits. And as of right now, there is just one technology that has a chance of getting probes there in time before they are lost forever. If we want to study the nearest star system, not in thousands of years, but in the coming decades, the probe will need to be able to travel at 1/5 the speed of light, which is equivalent to traveling 60,000 kilometers per second. This would be the same as circling the Earth 1.5 times every second. I have to admit, that's going rather quickly so far. In theory, only the breakthrough Starshot project could accomplish anything like that. The reasoning for this concept is based on the fact of regular photographs. First, a normal rocket will send 1,000 probes into orbit around the Earth. Each probe will weigh just 1 gram, which is far less than the weight of a chip. When the sails are put into place, an Earth-based laser system with a power output of 100 gigawatts will fire at them for 10 minutes. This will be enough time for a fleet of microprobes to begin traveling at 1/5 the speed of light, which is approximately 600 times faster than lightning. At this speed, even a minor impact with a mote of dust will be enough to wipe out both the sail and those probes. When the space probes are in place, the only thing they need to do is take a photo of the exoplanet, as there is only one chance, the main thing, I suppose, is to remember to remove the lens cap. After that, the photos will be transmitted to Earth, which would take about 5 more years to reach us today. Engineers are working tirelessly to launch starships so that here in this 21st century, we will be able to travel to other planets and get to know about the Proxima Centauri constellation. What do you think we will find there? How large is the chance of finding another civilization? Let us know your thoughts about this. Thank you for watching the video till the end. We're sure you'll love the following video. Click on the video on the screen to continue to be amazed at everything about space travel.